within the domain of security operations, you are still going to have to understand what is it that you want to do. Do you want to be in the defense side as a cybersecurity analyst? Do you want to be in the preventative side, more to the engineering side? Or do you want to be on the response side, incident responders? Security operations is a really big term. It's a really broad focus area. And there's many different roles that form part of security operations as a focus area. So in this area, we typically cover the concepts of detect, prevent, and respond. You'll have cybersecurity analysts with the ability to proactively investigate and detect threats based on alarms that's being raised. That's typically where the security operations center sits under security operations domain. And then that's typically where you'll find your SIM kind of controls. Then we'll have the security engineers who will sort of execute the prevent function of that. So the analyst has alerted as to a potential malicious detection, and we now need the engineers to go and build the systems, implement the systems, configure the controls, etc., to be able to prevent those attacks in future. And then we also have the responders that respond to the threat. So if we have a validated threat in our organization, then we need to have an entire response team to help us respond to those incidents. So let's break this down even further and let's talk about detection. With detection, we're looking to identify a potential threat. So we've got a set of controls in place. This could be a SIM, it could be some form of logging tools, it could be an endpoint detection and response system where threat hunting can be executed from. But we have a set of controls, and on those set of controls, we'll have some form of log. And we will have the security analysts then actively monitoring those logs, because there will be behavior that's normal, that we know is known to our organization. This is our IP addresses, this is our indicators, etc. And that is all good, normal behavior for our organization. And then we will have the possible malicious indicators. So these could be, you know, malicious file hashes that's been triggered, IP addresses, you know, we could see some types of attacks like, you know, denial of service attacks. We could see some botnets making out their communication to the CNC controllers, etc. And that's really typically what the security analyst will keep an eye on. And the security analyst will then be able to understand and investigate when something has triggered, whether it's actually a legitimate threat or not. And it's important to understand that this cybersecurity analyst operates before a threat has materialized or has been confirmed. And it's a really proactive kind of space where the analyst operates to try and understand whether this could be a potential threat, then stop that threat or the attack if it's just on one computer or one identity or in one application, etc., and then try and inform the engineers to be able to put the controls in place to prevent that. Now, some of the other tools here that I don't think is often mentioned, but that also forms part of the service, is actually tools like vulnerability management tools, and this is also where some of the blue teaming can take place. So where your ethical hackers would be, because once we identify vulnerabilities, we've got to understand how relevant and critical it is to our systems and our environment. And so that's where we have the blue team really come into play and help us to potentially try and exploit those threats, to see how exploitable it is in our environment so that we can remediate those threats where needed and in a priority as needed. Because if something is a critical vulnerability but it doesn't pertain to us, then it's irrelevant to our business. Context is everything. So we've got to understand that there's a larger team here that may not form part of the SOC itself, but they will be consulted as part of the security operations and the SOC operations. And more often we also see some of the red teamers come over and they try and exploit the potential vulnerabilities or threats that they find. And then we have the blue team trying to actively put in the right kind of controls to mitigate those threats identified by the red team. And it's really that, you know, proactive and defense kind of offense and defense kind of protection and enhancement of our cybersecurity defense side of things. So some of the typical roles that we see here is cybersecurity analysts, SOC analysts, vulnerability assessors, and sometimes in SOC itself, we also see some ethical hackers, etc. Now, if we're looking at the prevention side, this is the configuration that we do, the tools that we implement to actually go about preventing those attacks. So it's very important that these two things work cohesively. We've got to be able to detect something, even if we are not able to prevent it. But we work to find a way to try and prevent it. Visibility is everything, right? So visibility is first prize with everything. And if we can then prevent those attacks that we see, then great. So we have firewalling infrastructure here. We have app gateways. We have endpoint security. We have application security controls. We really have a lot of controls, and we require a lot of different skill sets and understanding of a lot of different platforms to be able to really execute on the security engineering, implementation of controls, configuration of controls, maintaining the controls, etc. And the roles that we typically see in here would be network security engineers, you know, that would maybe operate at controls on the network layer, application security engineers, DevSecOps type of professionals. We also see endpoint and system engineers that operate at the level of system security. So on the preventative side, more often we see the engineering staff complement that configure the systems, enhance the systems, and get our controls in place to prevent the attacks in future. And then finally, from a response perspective, so this is in the case where a threat was not blocked. So then from the response side, so this is in a case where the attack might have been a zero-day type attack, so never been seen before, no IOCs, and it passed through our detection controls without alerting the SOC analysts, or it has alerted the SOC analysts, but it's widespread and it's now an actual incident in our organization. And here is where the incident response comes into effect. Now, incident response is not just for a scenario where there is a massive incident and the organization is shutting down business operations and they need to respond to an incident. We actually have day-to-day incident responders as part of the SOC as well to investigate, you know, email threats, email compromises, etc. Because if we can understand how a small compromise happens, then it helps us to understand whether that small compromise, which was a part of a larger attack chain, and it helps us to then better enhance our detection controls. So you have incident responders that form part of the SOC team, and then you have incident responders that come from the outside and help us respond to threats. And most of the time we see in larger businesses, they may have an entire incident response team with incident response analysts, forensic investigators, etc. And then we also see that in smaller organizations, this might be a function that they rely on a third party for. And so we really require highly skilled incident responders, forensic investigators, malware analysts, malware reverse engineers, etc., to be able to help us with the function of responding to an incident. And here, what we want to achieve is really to contain the threat that we've observed, eradicate that threat, and make sure we can return our business processes to normal after an incident. So, do you have to be technical to work in the security operations area? And here, largely, the answer is going to be yes. From an analyst perspective, we require, you know, basic cybersecurity knowledge and understanding. From an engineer perspective, we require really a bit more advanced skills of managing different platforms, understanding different platforms, etc. And as I've mentioned, looking at the layered approach of defense in depth, you'll have firewalls, applications, endpoints, systems, etc. to secure. And so it's not expected that you need to work across the spectrum. So if you want to, you know, focus and zone into being a network security engineer, then definitely go and learn the networking components first and understand that first. So Even within the domain of security operations, you are still going to have to understand what is it that you want to do. Do you want to be in the defense side as a cybersecurity analyst? Do you want to be in the preventative side, more to the engineering side? Or do you want to be on the response side, incident responders? And for the incident response side, there may be more type of coding and analysis kind of experience, because you would need to do some form of reverse engineering to understand, you know, what that malware does, how that threat actually executes on systems, etc. There is a lot of focus on technical skills in the security operations domain. All right, friends, that is it for this video. I hope that you found it informative. In the next video, I will be covering threat intelligence as a focus domain. So if that's something you're interested in, definitely subscribe to make sure not to miss that video. Catch you next time. Bye.